the man that give you no break. Not even your eyes, you're not even no break. Hey, hey, bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when they come for you? Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do?
This special edition of Cops was filmed with the U.S. Marshal Service and cooperating law enforcement agencies. All suspects are considered innocent until proven guilty in a court of law.
Collective law enforcement is what Operation Sunrise is all about. Sunrise is the latest in a series of fugitive operations that the Marshal Service started over a decade ago. And since that time, through the collective efforts of Deputy United States Marshals, other federal agencies, and especially our friends in the state and local policing community, we have managed to arrest well over 20,000 fugitives. Now today, we're standing in the middle of our mobile command center, a center that we have affectionately nicknamed Red October. It was designed to be taken any place in the country at a moment's notice and set up an operation like this or a similar operational mission. Specifically, Sunrise is in five cities along the East Coast. Those five cities are Miami, Atlanta, Baltimore, Washington, New York, and Boston. We've decided this time to target on very high-profile and dangerous violent offenders. We're somewhere in the middle of that operation right now, and already we've arrested 38 murderers and confiscated over a half a million dollars in contraband properties and monies.
How you doing, bud?
How are you?
Okay, man. How's it going with you guys?
We're doing pretty well.
Listen, there's a particular case that's sparking a little bit of interest I need to get some background information on.
Okay.
You've got my name is Sharice Walker that you guys are looking for.
That's correct.
What's the scoop?
Well, she's been wanted now for about, on a federal warrant, on an indictment involving homicides, three homicides and some narcotics violations. Since 1979, she's been wanted, and we think we're getting real close.
Was she, in fact, believed to be one of the shooters, or did she just involved with a conspiracy? What's
as
the scoop
far as we
on
know,
that?
We believe she's
one of the shooters and one of the homicides.
Gotta have your people watch that one, man.
Oh, we sure will. We're gonna do that one fast and hard, buddy.
Okay. All right, let me know what happens. I got upstairs asking.
Yeah, you got it.
Okay, bud.
All right, take care, bud.
Talk to you, John.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Okay.
We know of three homicides that they were involved in. Her participation in the homicides was she would lure the guys into, the victims into an apartment, get them in a compromising position, and then the boyfriend and a couple other guys that would come out, execute them, and her responsibility was to get rid of the weapons. This is an indictment warrant. She was never arrested before. This is the only picture I have of her.
Okay.
But she knows she's wanted, all right?
She knows she's wanted. This is from March of this year. Just take a look at it. She's supposed to be real skinny, cracked out. Information says she's got a handgun. Her boyfriend, who's supposed to be in the apartment with her, he's, according to the informant, he's one on a state warrant. So we gotta, once we get her into custody, ID him, run him, and he goes too. The outside, it's got no fire escapes, but she had a rough night last night. She may throw a Peter Pan on us, you know? Let's get it.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay?
Let's do it,
guys.
Apartment 54.
This is a very streetwise fugitive. She knows how to stay in a place for a short time and then move on. She doesn't stay too long in one place. She moves because she knows she's got the cops looking for her and she knows she's got the bad guys looking for her.
U.S. Marshals with a warrant. Open up.
What you got,
Wade? Open up. It's coming down.
Put your hands on your head. Put your hands on your head.
That's her.
Cherise.
Finish what you don't. Peg, come in here.
Come here.
Derek, take him in out of the hallway here.
Take him in.
Cuff him and ID him.
Put him down.
Run up for Warrens.
Peggy,
up front. Peggy.
Joe, go back here.
You're under arrest, Cherise Walker.
Let's get out of here.
Put your
pants
on.
Put your pants on.
Put your pants on, Cherise.
Cherise?
I'm going to cuff her and then pat it down.
Hi, guy.
Don't tell me what I'm going to do. Move this out.
He's down.
Up on the wall. Hands up on the wall. Okay. All right. Cherise, just calm down.
Cherise, we have a federal warrant for your arrest. You are under arrest. You have a right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. You're entitled to an attorney. If you can't afford an attorney, the court will appoint you one. Do you understand your rights? Do you understand your rights?
Stay down.
You can make a phone call downtown.
Bob, how you doing?
All right, bud, how you doing?
Real good, fine. I got some good information for you.
What's that?
We got Cherie this morning.
Walker?
Yeah.
Ha, great.
Yeah.
Nobody get hurt?
Nobody got hurt.
Where is she now?
She's now at the Southern District of New York Courthouse.
Which is right across the street from me.
Right.
So,
she has an appearance today.
She has an appearance today before the judge, and the U.S. Attorney's very, very happy about this case.
Fantastic.
A lot of work.
That's great, man. Good. Tell him congratulations from all of us. We're really glad that nobody got hurt, and she's in jail.
That's it, buddy.
Okay.
Have a good day.
Take care, John.
Bye.
We'll see you, bud. Bye-bye.
Hello, you get hold of Tyrone?
Huh?
It's Tyrone, you get hold of him?
Tyrone? And I'm not going to do a CDC.
Okay, because I ain't going to be here real long.
Okay.
You know, I just want to find how much you're going to be there.
Okay, because he's not going to be there that long. He said, right to
speak. Okay. Go ahead. Uh-huh.
5661.
Oh, that hit number? Okay, man.
All right.
Okay, Nevada. Give me his home phone number and his beeper number just now.
That's on Bell?
Yeah, that's his home phone. It's an Essex number. So he's living in Essex.
This guy we're going for right now down in Baltimore County in Essex. He's wanted for a couple armed robberies. What we did on this guy here is we called him a couple times on his home phone and his girlfriend's. He's called me back on the beeper, which shows the number he wants me to call back, and that number is his home phone. So we're going to return back to that address now. We're going to do a scam real fast. I'm going to try to get him on the phone. Once I get him on the phone and can ID the positivity that he's in the house, we're going to do it.
Hello? Steve?
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Myers, get a hold of you. You tried to call.
Yeah, I know, and I speak
some things.
I got a
set of people. Okay, let me call him right back right now. I'll have him call you right now.
Okay.
Okay? Bye.
Open up, Stephen, boys.
Open up, Steve. You're completely surrounded. Open up or the door's coming down.
Hey, George.
Down!
Any lights here?
Put your hands behind your back.
What'd I do? What did I do?
Who's that?
He didn't answer the door.
Can I get some things?
Another bad one bites the dust.
How you doing, Mike?
Good.
Listen, we got a call, an inquiry about one of your targets, Darnell Hines. What's the scoop with this guy?
Darnell Hines, he's wanted homicide, murder one, Baltimore City one.
This is a guy that pumped four shots in the guy when he was down. It looks like we got something working on the north side, and we're going to hit it tomorrow.
What I want is two uniforms.
uniforms in the rear, one or two uniforms in the front. It's got to be approached with caution. There's no reason to go busting in there. Hines will kill you if he gets a chance.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
Oh, yeah, he's prepared. He ain't going to be taken, he said.
Yeah.
And, you know, that was one of his comments, yeah. He ain't going to be taken. Like last night, that guy, that's exactly what Andre said, remember? He wasn't going to be taken alive. Of course, he was right. Yeah.
Okay, mount up. Ready to roll.
Watch it, people.
Please, open up. Let's go.
Mount your hands up, pal.
Let's go.
Put those hands up.
On the ground.
On the ground.
On the ground.
On the ground, man. Hey, cut and get caught now. That's your hands behind your back.
Stop looking for you.
Nothing in here.
20 grams.
Ain't nothing in here.
20 grams. That's
the ground.
Ain't nothing in here.
Whoa, wait. Whoa, 20 ground. He don't want you getting in these pockets.
Nothing.
Ain't
no
nothing. Yeah,
money.
A couple dollars.
Few
dollars, right,
boss? Ain't no nothing money. Is a lot of this money?
Well, there's probably $20,000,
$10,500.
Just said $9,500.
Well, $10,500 you don't own no more, my friend.
Right, yeah.
Major drug dealer. That's what makes the job worthwhile, is taking people that are responsible for homicides, armed robberies. It just makes it worthwhile when you take them off the street to make it a little safer for people out there that have been out there working and working hard all their lives to get what they have. Or you got a guy like this that wants to come along and try to take it away from you in 5 minutes after you've worked all your life for it. It kind of pumps you. It makes you want to just hurry to the next one.
This fellow we were talking about here, I'm looking at his rap sheet. We're going back to 1971 on this fella. He's, we go back to burglary,
yeah.
Aggravated batteries, paroles from these cases, more burglaries, more paroles, assaults, and this. This fella's got a rap sheet probably 7 feet long.
He looks like he's pretty well tattooed, too. This fella's apparently been around.
He's got a biker or these jailhouse-type tattoos or what?
Well, it just shows he's heavily tattooed. I don't know. I guess what they are.
Okay.
So, as soon as we get something back, I'll get back with you, and you can advise who needs to be advised that he is in custody.
Okay, brother.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
I'm going to try to get these guys one more time. As many of y'all know, we spent all night, two nights, trying to set them up to get them to come to us. We've got information today where Raymond and Tink both are living.
You'll notice they got evidently the Ku Klux Klan cross up here in the back of this guy's house. Evidently, these people are affiliated. He's the Grand Wizard.
Knights of the Ku Klux Klan.
Okay. So these people, everybody in these trailers and houses could also possibly be associates and allies of the guys here.
The history of Raymond, he's never at one place real long. That's why I want to go ahead and hit it tonight, because there's no guarantees coming back tomorrow.
There you go. They draping burlap, getting ready to burn it.
Okay,
Let's go. We're on this guy's property.
Welcome to the South.
Police!
Get the door.
Police! Open the door. On the ground, right now.
Get back. Get on the ground.
Doors in the house.
Man, my kids are in. Please don't scare my kids, okay?
Hands up! Don't move!
All right.
Don't move!
My kids are there. Please don't scare me.
Step back here, man. Get out of the way.
I need a light.
Okay.
Where are they at?
Okay.
One in there. Drop your damn suit.
Okay, come on back.
There's your boy, Mark.
Just check this, dude.
Yeah.
We gotta go by Code 13 and pick up the bird.
We gotta go by view.
I said, I always heard the marshals always get their men. Now I know it's true.
Bob.
Yes?
Remember the Orlando Hernandez Oviedo case I told you about?
That was the cocaine guy out of Alabama.
Yes.
Yes.
OCDF case, I guess it was originally an FBI case up there, and it was sent down for us to work.
Yeah.
Yeah, they had the surveillance going here for several days now.
The subject we're looking for, they were transporting cocaine and... they're real big into Santeria, which it's a religion stemming out of Cuba, which comes out of Africa. And to show his dedication to his God, he cut the end of his finger off, cut it off himself. I don't know why he did that. And we just got some information today that he's been seen less than an hour ago in this area right here.
That's our boy. Got it. That's our guy right there.
You better hurry up. Subjects are coming out of the pharmacy.
All right, I'm going to walk up to them, guys, so make it quick. Y'all ready?
Yeah, I'm rolling. This is 2102.
I'm ready. Let's go.
Where's he at?
I'm by the pharmacy. The pharmacy's right here. Where's
the pharmacy? It's a florist.
There he is. He's busting.
Give it up, baby. Take the baby. Take the baby. Come here.
No.
Take the baby.
Coge la niña.
La niña.
All right, take the baby.
Go ahead. Get on the car. Get on the car.
Oh, my God. La niña.
¿Entiendes inglés? Orlando, ¿entiendes inglés? ¿Traes pistola?
No, no traigo nada.
¿Nada? ¿Nada?
Come stand up.
That's first. ¿Tú tienes pistola? ¿Traes pistola? Orlando Hernández? ¿Cómo te llamas? Te llamas Orlando Hernández.
Okay, come on. I got a mark. I'll put him in.
Oh. That was 100.
But the FBI is now going to transport him with U.S. Marshals and the Metro-Dade Police over to the FBI headquarters for processing.
Well, they popped him about 2:50 this afternoon.
All right. Well, that's great. Tell those guys you did a super job, man.
I sure will.
All right, Don.
Okay.
Thanks for calling.
Talk to you next time.
Here's some of the final paperwork.
We're wrapped, huh?
Yes, sir.
There you go.
Thank you.
Well, what do you think?
We got well over 1,000 arrests with 34 homicides to date. We've got over $500,000 in assets.
Out of 212 operational people that we've had up to this point, not one single injury. That's the amazing statistic.
You know, we're doing a good job. So let's shut Red October down, and we'll move it into a new neighborhood a few months from now, huh?
Looking forward to that.
Sounds great. Right.
Good job.
Thank you, sir.
132 in Bush. I've got him at gunpoint.
Okay, gunpoint. 132 in Bush. Covers code 3.
Okay, we're still kind of code 3.